loves me. 4 and 5, he's by my side. 6 and 7, he's the way to heaven. 8, 9, 10, he's singing again. I can always count on him. I can always count on Jesus. I can always count on Jesus.
I have a really good friend, and her name is Vianna. I love to talk with her, and she listens to me. I have made it a habit to talk to her about everything. She is such a good friend. Hey, do you have a good friend that you like to talk to? That's awesome. There's someone else I love to talk with, too. It's God. I can't see God like I can see Vianna, but I know that He's there because I feel close to Him. The way I talk with God is by praying. I have made it a habit to pray before I eat and thank God for my food. And I pray before I go to sleep at night and thank God for being with me all day. But I pray at other times all day long too. What exactly is praying? Well, praying is just talking with God. Praying is talking with God just like I talk with my friend V. God loves me and cares about me. He loves it when I talk with Him. I can talk with God. Let's say that together. I can talk with God. Just today, Willer found a box by the opening of his burrow. He asked Kyle to come out and see what was in the box. I wonder what it could be. Do you guys want to see what Willard found? I can't hear you. All right, let's go.
Oh, look at you. You're so soft and sweet. Tor.
Oh, look at the black and white one in there, Willard. It's so cute.
Oh, they're both so cute.
Hey, kids, would you like to see what's in this box? Here, let's try and open it. Ready? Here we go. Right there. Oh, and ta-da!
Oh, careful so they don't get away.
Oh, look at them. Hey, where did they come from, Willard?
Oh, well, I heard something outside my burrow, and when I came up to see what it was, there was this box. I peeked inside, and there they were, the sweetest, softest, cutest kittens. Oh, look at them, they're so cute.
They're so cute. Hey, I guess the person that left them there wasn't able to care for them and knew that you would take care of them.
Oh, well, I do try to make it a habit of being caring.
That's a great habit, Willard. These guys are so cute. Hey, you know, Willard, God created these little kittens. I can see how wonderful God is when I look at them.
Oh, cute little kittens, you're so sweet.
Hey, what are you gonna do with them?
Oh, I don't know yet. Oh, I hear you, little kitties. What do you think is wrong with them? Why are they meowing so loud?
Willard, maybe they're hungry?
Oh, I know.
Willard, carrots?
Well, yeah, carrots.
Willard, kittens don't eat carrots.
They don't?
No, they need milk.
Milk? Oh, Kyle, what are we going to do? I only have carrots, and those kittens, they look really hungry.
Well, Willard, we could pray. The Bible tells me that I can talk with God.
But isn't God really, really far away?
Well, one of the Bible verses that I like is Psalm 145, verse 18. It says that God is close to all who call on Him in the truth.
That doesn't sound very far at all. God is close, but isn't God really busy? Maybe He doesn't have time to help me care for these kittens.
Well, another verse in the Bible I like says God sees and cares about even a little bird that falls to the ground. If God isn't too busy to care about a little bird, I know He has time to care about these hungry kittens we have here.
Oh, I'm getting worried about the kitties. They're getting really hungry. Let me guess, I bet you have a verse for that too.
I do, Willard. 1 Peter 5:7 says you can give all your worries and cares to God because He cares about you, Willard.
God cares about me and God cares about these kitties? Oh, we better pray.
Alrighty, go ahead. Willard, go ahead, pray.
I don't know what to say, Kyle.
Well, maybe I can help you here. What if I asked you what was in the box?
I would say there's kittens in the box.
And what if I asked you what do the kittens need?
I would say they were really hungry and needed milk.
Well, Willard, just like I'm your friend and you can talk with me and tell me things, God is your friend and you can talk with Him too. Now say it with an I. Ready?
I can talk with God. Okay, Kyle, that's easy. I can say that. I can talk with God. I like talking with you. You're a good listener.
God is a good listener too. Okay, so let's try again. Remember, tell God what is in the box and that the kittens are really hungry.
Okay. Hi, God. It's me, your friend Willard. I have a box with some of the sweetest kittens here. Kyle told me that the Bible says you're really close by. How was that?
Great. Right, keep going, though. Keep talking, Willard.
Okay. And Kyle told me that the Bible says you care about even a little tiny bird when it falls on the ground. Still good?
Yeah, that's awesome. Keep on going, though, Willard.
So, God, I'm really worried about these little kittens because they're really, really super hungry. Kyle told me that I can give my worries to you because you care a whole bunch. So can you help us figure out how to feed these sweet baby kittens? Thank you, God. How did I do, Kyle?
Oh, great, Willard. You know, talking with God is just like talking with a friend. He is a good, good friend. Hey, let's say that again.
I can talk with God.
One other lesson we can learn from the Bible is that we can talk to God anytime, anywhere.
Are you sure he wouldn't be bothered by me talking to him in the middle of the night?
Nope. He wants us to keep on asking when we need help. Hey, that reminds me of a Bible story. One day, Jesus was teaching the disciples about prayer. Jesus told them this story. What if you went to a friend's house really late at night, knocked on the door shouting, "I need to borrow 3 loaves of bread because a friend of mine has come for a visit and I have nothing for him to eat." But because it is late at night and he's trying to sleep, he says, "Don't bother me. The door is locked for the night and my family and I are all in bed. I can't help you." But you just keep on knocking and knocking and knocking. Finally, he gets up and opens the door. He gives you whatever you need because you kept on knocking. Well, just like the man who kept knocking on the door of his friend's house, Jesus taught the people that they were to keep on asking God for what they needed. Jesus said this, "Keep on knocking and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, everyone who seeks finds, and to everyone who knocks, the door will be opened."
God opens the door for me when I knock?
Yes.
And when I pray, that's how I knock?
You're right.
And praying is just talking to God.
You got it again, Willard.
Well, I can talk with God.
Hey, I want to say that with you. Let's say it together.
I can talk with God. You know, Kyle, speaking of knocking on the door, I just remembered Steve. He knocked on our door just a few minutes ago and brought us some snacks. What did he bring, Kyle?
Yeah, he did. He dropped us a bag. Let's see if I can find it. He gave us a bag here. Let's see. Oh, here it is. Oh, let's see what it is, Willard. Let's open it up. Ooh, look at that. And what's this?
Chocolate chip cookies and milk.
Ooh, that is awesome.
Kyle, I think God heard my prayer because I kept asking for help.
He sure did, Willard. You can talk with God. And isn't God as good as a friend? Hey, let's pour some milk in our bowl so these little kittens can eat, okay?
Yep. Oh, and they're such cute kittens.
When someone asks me to pray, sometimes I might not be able to think of anything to say. But when I remember that praying is just talking with God, then I have a lot to say. I love to talk to God because He is close to me. He cares about me and He loves me. God may not always answer my prayers right away like He did with the milk for the kittens. And sometimes it might take a while because God wants me to learn how to wait and trust Him. God loves you so much. He's close to you. He cares about you. When you pray, you're just talking to God. He's your friend, and talking with Him is a really good habit. I can talk with God. Let's say that together. I can talk with God. Our memory verse for this series is Ephesians 4, 23 through 24. You can find it in your hands-on Bible on page 1165. Instead, let the Spirit renew your thoughts and attitude. Put on your new nature, created to be like God, truly righteous and holy. Keep on looking for God and all the beautiful things that He has created. Keep on knocking at His door and He will open it so that you can talk together. And if you haven't asked God to come into your heart, you can just talk to Him in a prayer and He will come into your heart. Let's pray right now. Dear God, thank you for being a part of my life. Thank you for loving me and caring for me. And thank you that I can talk to you. I will talk to you all the time. Amen. See you next time.